Hello everybody, my name is Faethodas and here we are with one more new video. This video is some kind of a farming guide for mostly new players. First of all, let me say that if you are new players in Titan Quest and you watch this video, consider subscribing to this channel because we have more content in this channel already and more content is going to come in the future for this game. And also check the links down in the description because we have more Titan Quest guides for new players and old players, for everybody to understand better the game maybe. And other than that, this is a farming, some kind of a guide, farming a guide video for new characters. As you can see, this is a character level 14. This is one of my new builds anyway. And I decided to go and do some farming with this character on the boss Nissos. Nissos is one of the first bosses in this game, the second big boss we would say in this game when you start the first act in Act 1. And after I reached this area here, we are here in the Parnassus Hinterlands. We can see the waypoint down there. It is this waypoint here. We are here, here starts the game. We are currently here in this waypoint, which is this one here. Let's see. So, when first of all, let me tell you how I made this farm. First of all, I chose to farm this boss, Nissos boss, with this character, which is level 13. You can see it is now level 14. But when I started farming this boss, this character was level 13, which means after 50 runs on this boss, I gained one full level by farming this boss 50 runs on normal difficulty. So, now the character is level 14. I chose to farm this boss with a character level higher than what it normally would be. For example, this boss is in this area. It is outside of Sparta. When you reach this boss, your character is around 6 to 8 level, and the boss is at about 8 to 10 level. But I decided to farm this boss with a bit higher level player character, because when you farm bosses, generally you want your characters to be stronger than the bosses, so your farm would be much faster actually. Because if your character is level 8, and for example, if your character reaches this boss here for the first time, and your character is around level 8, and the boss is around level 8 to 10, and you fight this boss, the boss will be challenging. You will not beat the boss easily. Which means that it takes lots of time to farm the boss when you meet the boss the first time. So, I chose to go with this character when this character was at level 13, and the farming was very fast, and I farmed 50 times, I ran 50 times against this boss and the small area of that boss, and I farmed and I gained one level. I went up to level 14 and I found all of these items that you see here, all of these items down here that you see in this tab. And these three items were found during these 50 runs against this boss. And the second thing you need to remember is that how did I do these 50 runs? So, when you load the game from your desktop for the first time, actually every time that you load the game has a seed number. This is how we call it, a seed number. It creates automatically a random seed number, which means that this seed number determines how good, how frequent drops you will get from the game, how good epic or legendary items you will get from the game, how good your drops will be overall. And to make sure that I would have at least an average seed during my 50 runs, I was exiting the game after every 10 runs, and I was loading the game again from the desktop every 10 runs. This way I was changing the seed number. It changes randomly, automatically, And this way I was trying to make sure that I would have an average good, an average at least seed number that would give me maybe sometimes bad chances for good drops and maybe sometimes better chances for good drops. So, after we said all of these things, let's go. Here is how you do this run, if you go to perform this run. For example, I reached this area with this character, then I chose to do this run. You go to Sparta. This boss is outside of Sparta. If, for example, you have reached the same place and you have stopped in the Parnassus area, exactly the same as I have stopped there, and you got to farm this boss's 50 runs, you come here, you activate this Reaper Fountain. So, every time you exit the game and you load this character will spawn here in this area, and you don't have to come from that Parnassus area every time here to farm the boss. Later, after you finish your farming runs, you go to waypoint, you choose Parnassus waypoint, and you come here. This waypoint is next, almost next to this Rebirth Fountain, where you stopped at the last time before you decided to start farming this Nisus boss, and then you can keep going on with your game. So this is a very good area to stop before you start farming, because you have the Rebirth Fountain next to the waypoint. Let's go back. Sparta. So, I will go now there. I will do, this is going to be my 51, number 51 farming run. And I will kill these enemies here in this area. I will show you how I farm this boss. We come all the way here. We meet some enemies. Some animals, birds and boars. From these boars we can find this charm here, boar hide. This charm is a good one. It gives you, if you enhance your armor with this charm, it gives you more armor, more bleeding resistance, and the charm bonus can be a random one, bleeding resistance or other types of bonus. Here is the boss, as we can see. As you can see, it is very close to this area, to the waypoint, of course, to the Rebirth Fountain. It is very close. The farm is all about killing these enemies here, and these enemies here. Let's go, let's kill these enemies here first. This is the Nisus boss, as you can see, it is level 9. He dropped just a yellow item. Health potion, some gold, we have two more shedders here to kill, no drops. We have this majestic chest here. This chest is always a majestic one, it is always the same type. If you are lucky, sometimes in this game there is a bug, which is the bug of double chests, which means that sometimes if you are lucky this bug appears and instead of one chest here you find two chests. This does not happen very often, but maybe. Sometimes maybe it happens. You open the chest and you see some items. You pick up the gold and every other item that you would like to pick up. Then you come here. You kill some more enemies. And as we can see, we have three more containers. This is why we come here. We get always these three containers here. Always. And of course, these containers give items, and sometimes, if we are lucky, maybe we can find some good items from these containers. So, this is actually the farming run. You do this time, I did this time 50 times. You come all the way from here, here from Sparta, you come around here, you kill some boars here and some birds maybe. You come here, kill the boss here at the cedars, kill the cedars here, open the majestic chest here, kill some enemies here and open these three containers. And then you exit the game and you repeat the process. This is the farming run. Now, there are some details you have to remember. If you play a mage character, my character, this one, is a mage one. It plays with intelligence mostly, intelligence-based build, elementalist. It plays with storm and earth masteries. And You will not fight from cedars and boards. Of course, these enemies here, you will not fight any weapons for or other items with intelligence based items, especially staves. You will not fight staves. So if you play a mage class, maybe this is not the best area to farm for your class. But the majestic chest at these three containers can drop items for every class, even for mage classes. So again, now even if you cannot find good items from the enemies in this area, you can find good items for mage classes from these four containers. But the truth is that since this is the beginning of the game, if you have a good amount of strength, for example, now I have 90 points of strength here, because mostly of my items, this item here and maybe some other items that I have equipped that give strength. Do I have any more items? No? No. Okay. Only this item gives some strength. I get some strength probably from this master here. So, sometimes when you are low level, maybe even from cedars, you can find some items that you can use on your mage builds. For example, this item drops from cedars only. It is a mastery frequent item, which means it is an item that drops only from certain enemies. Monster infrequent items in this game drop only from certain monsters. This is why we call them mastery frequents. This item, for example, and also this shield, these two items drop only from cedars. Only from cedars. So, I play with an intelligence based class, level 14, but as you can see, this is a cedar item, but I can still use it. This item has requirements of strength and dexterity, but I can still use it. Because my strength currently is enough for me to equip this item. So even if these enemies, cedars, do not give any weapons or any staves, usually, in this area, in particular, maybe you can find shields or these armor items that can help you, for now at least. You can equip these items, get maybe more armor, as you can see here, combined armor, 117, and 111 with this one. With this one it goes up and you gain movement speed and some very nice stats. And also from the containers, now I will tell you all of these items that you see here, all of these items here. These three items were found by these 50 runs. So, I found the Silver Blood Epic Spear, which is very powerful to find it here. If you play, of course, with dexterity-based classes and you find this one here on level, you have a character level 13, 14 or 10 or whatever, maybe you have already this dexterity requirement and you can equip this one. If you equip this one can take you through the whole normal difficulty. It is a powerful weapon for normal difficulty. And you can find it here in this area, as I did. The Trapper Spear is a mastery frequent item that drops again from cedars. So, again, if you play with strength or dexterity based classes, you can use this one. As you can see, I can already equip it, even though I play with an intelligence class. I can still equip it because my character, the requirements of this item are low, dexterity and strength, and I have these requirements covered, so I can use it. If I want to go, for example, with this item, even though I play with an intelligence mage class, I can still use shields and spears for now, for the beginning of the game. Of this journey. Okay, I have to take it off. This is a very nice item because, you know, in green, yellow, white and mastery frequent items with this color of this Trapper Spear, the name Trapper Spear color, you can attach relics or charms. Of course, each different relic and charm can be attached in different items, but you can put this one, for example, it can be enchanted in all weapons. You can put it here, enchant it here, and make this one even more powerful, and continue playing with this one if you want. I also found 1, 2, 3 staves. These three staves, all of these three staves are very good staves. I can equip these staves and use these staves with my build currently. Even though my build is level 14, these 3 staves could be very useful for this build. And of course I can attach in these 3 staves items like this one that can be attached on weapons. Which means that still we can find good items in these farming runs. Even for mage classes weapons, these are weapons for mage classes. And very good weapons, staves. Very good, very powerful. I have also found the Elos Rage, an epic item. It grants a skill on slot. It requires more strength, of course, to be equipped. Maybe this one is not for this class, mage class, but you know, there are many builds that you can play that play with strength, not intelligence, that you can use an item like this one. The same applies to this Theban Shield, which is also a very powerful item for normal difficulty, for the start of normal difficulty. It is also a set item, Theban Panoply. I found it here in this area. Necromancer's Leggings, also a powerful item for this level. It is also a mage item, as you can see, required intelligence 116 and dexterity 72 at level 10. You can put it here. And again, here we can see that we gain vitality resistance and some armor. Here, this is an upgrade. I also found the death caps. One more item, set item. It belongs to the same set as this one. So I found these two items here from this farming grants in this area. Necromancer's habiliment set. Which means that I can equip these two items now, and also I can get the bonus of this set, the two-piece set bonus, which is very useful. And as I said before, I found these 3 mastery frequent items, shield, and armor, chest armor. These 3 items are all powerful. For this level, for normal difficulty, these 3 items are powerful. Let's not forget again that in mastery frequent items, items with this color on the name of the item, we can attach a relic or a charm, and we can make these items even more powerful. So if we wanted, we could do this move here and continue playing with this one for now at least. And have a better armor, better survivability, and better performance for our builds. Especially if our builds are based on strength or dexterity, mostly, because for intelligence it is still useful, as you can see, for an intelligence class, but after we start leveling up, we will need something better for intelligence classes, probably. But it is still very useful. Very useful, even for this class here, I can still use it and have better performance for my build. And I also found this arcane formula. This is the Shroud of Eternal Night. I found this one from this chest, the majestic chest here. And this is one of the best formulas for normal difficulty. Not just only for the start of normal difficulty, but the whole normal difficulty. This is a powerful formula for normal difficulty. It also can be used in epic difficulty, it is such that strong. It provides damage over time, energy leech over time, flat damage, piercing and physical, vitality damage, resistance and stun resistance. Stun resistance is very important for, especially for mage builds that don't use any shields, and they don't have so good armor, because you know, if you get stunned from enemies, especially melee enemies, they stun you, you cannot move, you cannot do anything, they start hitting you. And if you don't have good armor or any shield, they can kill you very easily. So this is very powerful, a very powerful formula. And I found it from this chest here. And also, I found, let me put this back here, so we can see all the items that we found. I found the Storm Eye Ring, an epic ring, powerful ring for this level. Lightning damage and intelligence for mage classes mostly. I found the Brimstone. Again, some good resistances, burn damage, fire burn damage. Very powerful ring for normal difficulty. I found this one. This is also a powerful ring for normal difficulty. This one is a green one, which means we can apply a relic or a charm that can be applied, of course, on jewels, and we can make this ring even more powerful. This one gives you strength and health, which more health for survivability and more strength if you want to increase your strength a little bit and be able to equip items that require more strength to be equipped. And these three rings are very nice, very powerful for now, especially these two. And I also found the boar hide, as we said before. While you kill boars in this area, they sometimes drop this boar hide charm. And this charm can be applied on all armor. All armor means 1, 2, 3, 4 slots. These 4 slots are the slots of armor. And if you have a white, yellow, green or mastery frequent item with this color, let's call it dark green or whatever, you can apply this item, this charm, to make your survivability even better. And also from cedars we can find the essence of Prometheus flame, which can be enchanted attached to weapons only, all types of weapons. And of course it is a powerful relic which can help very much with the damage output of your build. So these are the items that I found after 50 farming runs in this area on normal difficulty with a low level character. And here the big question comes: is it worth it farming with a low level character on normal difficulty this area, for example? The answer is yes. I would say yes, it is worth it, because let's not forget after all that this is a game of luck. Different players have a different experience on games, on RNG games that depend on luck. They get different loot, which means I might have found only 3, 7, about 15 items, 15 good items from 50 runs. But some other players may fight double the items, 30 items. Some other players, if they have better luck, they could fight 40 or 50 items, good items, to upgrade their low level characters. We are talking about level 13 to 15 now. Let's not forget that I started farming at level 13. Let's not forget also that by doing these 50 runs, a level 13 character reaches level 14. It gains a full level, so it is worth it also if you want to gain one more level. Yes, it is worth it, because as we can see, I found some items that I can upgrade right now my build. Actually, I can upgrade my build right now if I want to use this armor. This gives me better survivability. I can use a spear and a shield if I want to have even better survivability, or I can use some better staves, this one or this one, and I can also use this one, which is better than this one, and this one, which is probably better than this one. And these two together belong to the same set that give more set bonuses. And I can upgrade my jewels, at least one of my jewels. This is very powerful here. And I also can attach some relics or charms on some items. And I also have found this one. Now the only thing remaining is to find the materials for me to be able to create this one and put it here and have one of the best artifacts for normal difficulty. One of the best artifacts, this one. So yeah, if you like farming farming in games like this, and if you are not rushing through the campaign of the game, then it is a good idea if you have a character about level. It is better for you to have a character in a higher level than the boss that you want to farm. For example, as we saw right now, Nisos boss spawns at around level 9 to 10. So with my character level 13, my farming runs were very fast and very easy. So yeah, and I can still find items that can upgrade my build when I'm level 13 or 14 or even 15, which means that it is better for you to have a character a bit higher level than the boss that you are going to farm. So yeah, my opinion is that If you don't go to rush through the main campaign, or normal difficulty at least, come here, farm this boss and get some good loot for your build and upgrade your build. This is it, guys, for this video. I don't know if it is useful for you, especially for new players, because this guide is for new players. Advanced players don't need such a guide, I think. If you have any questions, leave a comment below. I will try to reply as soon as possible. And I will see you very soon with more videos for both beginners and more advanced players for Titan Quest. We have lots and lots of videos coming. Game guides and gameplay videos and build guides. So I will see you very soon. Have fun and good farming.